Valve has been promising a SteamOS 3 ISO for ages, for over a year at this point, in fact, yet it has failed to materialize. Granted, the release of the new desktop client has probably freed up some resources for their development team, and maybe we will see a SteamOS ISO release soon. And many of us have been waiting with bated breath for that release, myself included. But I've started to wonder, how necessary is it, actually? And you know, talking about this right off the bat, many folks will probably point to HoloISO, which is a community-made Linux distribution based on the Steam Deck recovery image. From their project page, quote, "This project attempts to bring the Steam Deck's SteamOS Holo distribution into a generic installable format and provide a close-to-official SteamOS experience. The main point of this project focuses on re-implementing proprietary, as in only runs on the deck, components that the Steam client, SteamOS itself, GameScope, and user-created applications on the Steam Deck rely on." And when it works, HoloISO is great. It's essentially SteamOS 3, but community-maintained. But it's only great when it works. And that is to say, I've tried it before and haven't had much luck with it. I tried installing it on an NVIDIA-based system, and it wouldn't even boot. I tried installing it on my GPD Win 2 with an Intel chip, and no luck there. I tried it on my System 76 Thalia, thinking, hey, it's got an AMD APU, probably it'll work. And despite my best efforts, I had absolutely no luck. The problem is, it needs a fairly specific hardware configuration to get off the ground, and I just don't have the patience to coax it into running. But HoloISO isn't the only gaming-focused Linux distribution out there. Not by a long shot, there's many of them you'll see on screen right here, but one I want to focus on is WinesapOS, which I've personally had more luck with. Again, WinesapOS is based on the Steam Deck recovery image, and from their project page, quote, "WinesapOS makes it easy to set up Linux and play games off an internal or portable external drive. This project provides an opinionated installation of Linux. It can be used on a flash drive, an SD card, hard disk, solid-state drive, NVMe, or any other storage device. Both internal and external devices are fully supported. The release images are based on SteamOS 3 and the KDE Plasma desktop environment to align with what Valve's Steam Deck uses. Software for various games launchers are pre-installed. Additional drivers are installed to support Macs with Intel processors." Now, WinesapOS can be run from a USB drive, and it can be installed and used from internal storage. It can run on Intel Macs, your desktop PC, and heck, even a hacked PS4. It's also enormous. The minimal image is 4 gigabytes, and the biggest version is 13 gigabytes. And granted, that's not for nothing. I mean, it comes with preloaded applications and tons of other stuff that I don't have time to get into here. Now, WinesapOS has some fairly good documentation and much wider hardware support, though it's still not perfect. Now, as I mentioned, both of these distros are actually based on SteamOS recovery image, and that's cool. That means that they're designed for gaming from the get-go. And WinesapOS, to its credit, comes with even more stuff. It has Heroic Games Launcher, Lutris, ProSynop QT, out of the box. That's cool. But what if I told you that there was a Linux distro that predates the Steam Deck, that was designed for gaming, and was, and I think still is, a better SteamOS than SteamOS? Before we get into that, I've got to ask you if you're enjoying this video. If you are, why not like that smash button? It's the best way to tell YouTube you want to see more videos like this. And I want to say thank you to Webfreak for his continued support of the work I'm doing here at such a high level. Now, it's because of Webfreak and the 72 other folks that support what I do here that I'm able to keep these lights on. If you believe in the work that I'm doing and you want to join the growing community of folks supporting this show, use the links below to make your pledge. And thanks. So what is this mysterious SteamOS competitor? They bill their system thusly. ChimeraOS is an operating system that provides an out-of-the-box couch gaming experience. After installation, boot directly into Steam Big Picture mode and start playing your favorite games. If you want Steam in your living room, you want ChimeraOS. Now, instead of the Steam Deck recovery image, ChimeraOS is based on Arch Linux. Arch is a cutting-edge Linux-based operating system that focuses on maximizing customizability. This makes it a great choice for acting as a base for specialized systems. But ChimeraOS is more than it seems here. I've got ChimeraOS installed on my System 76 Thalia in my living room. I've got my Steam controller connected via a USB dongle, and you can play all your favorite games on this just like you would your Steam Deck, but with the added benefit of broad hardware support. The first thing that you'll notice is that Chimera boots directly into Steam Deck mode. And I know that they said big picture mode, but it's specifically Steam Deck mode. I mean, it thinks it's a Steam Deck. All of the text on the screen looks like it's a Steam Deck. And you can also drop into desktop mode here. Just hit the power menu and then choose desktop mode. But here's where things are different. It's not running KDE Plasma Desktop like SteamOS does. Instead, it's running my preferred desktop environment, GNOME. And yes, it's pronounced GNOME, even though it's spelled GNOME. It's called a heteronym. That's a thing in English. Don't get mad at me, I didn't name it GNOME. Anyway, ChimeraOS uses GNOME, and as such, it may feel a bit different to people who are not familiar with this UI. But it's got all the same functionality as SteamOS's desktop mode. ChimeraOS also offers a pretty awesome feature, the Chimera web app. This gives you a web-based front end that will allow you to install games remotely. This is a truly awesome feature and one that I respect. Logging into Epic and GOG could be a little easier, more straightforward for a new user. As a web developer, I can think of a few magic bits of JavaScript that could handle some of the more technical things here, but once it's set up, you don't have to worry about it again. I used this method to set up a few GOG games on my Steam Deck, and once you restart Steam, these games have been added to your non-Steam section of your library, and you can manage and launch them just as you would any other game. And to be honest, ChimeraOS, with its immutable file system, use of flatpaks, implementation of the true Steam compositor, and its Arch base, all of that combined is seemingly the inspiration for SteamOS 3. Plus, ChimeraOS has the best support for both integrated and discrete GPUs of all the distros we've talked about today. All of this together has me asking, do we really need an official SteamOS 3 ISO? SteamOS 3 as an ISO would mean that other hardware vendors would be able to ship the OS with their systems, but how likely is that to happen? I'm not sure. I do think that it's more likely for SteamOS to ship from an OEM than having ChimeraOS ship from an OEM, but that's more of like a big business-to-business thing. SteamOS also has the advantage of being integrated directly into the Steam ecosystem. Remotely managing your deck could be a simple affair using the desktop Steam client. And there's a benefit to having the comprehensive Steam ecosystem in place. On the other hand, ChimeraOS runs Steam out of the box in the DeX game mode. It's nearly a drop-in replacement for SteamOS, and you'd be hard-pressed to tell if you're running SteamOS or Chimera if you weren't really looking that hard. So if you're waiting for the official SteamOS 3 image from Valve to land, you don't really need to. ChimeraOS is a simple, straightforward, and easy way for you to build a modern SteamOS-like machine today. And it provides several interesting features that are sure to please both console and PC gamers alike. I want to know what you think, though. Have you tried any of the distros that we talked about in today's video? I want to hear your thoughts. Are you still waiting for the official SteamOS 3 release? Sound off in the comments below. Now, I want to shout out my friends on Patreon, my YouTube members, and our ViewSync premium subscribers who make what I do here a reality. If you believe in the work that I'm doing, you can use the links below to support the show. It's all greatly appreciated. That's going to do it for now, though. Thank you so much for spending your time with me here today, and I'll see you in the next one.